Chairman Garbarino, Ranking Member Swalwell, and members of the Subcommittee, thank you for the opportunity to testify on securing the industrial control systems that underpin our nation's water sector. I am Marty Edwards, Deputy Chief Technology Officer for Operational Technology and Internet of Things at Tenable, the leading cybersecurity exposure management company with 43,000 customers worldwide, including just about every federal department and multiple critical infrastructure providers. In recent years, there has been an increase of successful cyber attacks against U.S. infrastructure, including the water sector. In November, attackers targeted the Municipal Water Authority of Aliquippa, Pennsylvania, exploiting OT assets that were directly accessible from the internet. Just last week, we learned of Chinese attempts to plant malware within U.S. critical infrastructure systems, including water treatment plants. Efforts to infiltrate the underlying systems that support not only the daily lives of Americans, but also the economy, are emerging as an acute national security risk. We must accept that our national security defense requires securing all of the systems that keep U.S. water infrastructure operational. There is no doubt that the history of OT systems and the current challenge of IT, OT, and even IoT convergence makes securing our critical infrastructure more difficult. But we have the tools and resources to be successful. The federal government has several ongoing initiatives to improve critical infrastructure, OT, and IoT security, including for the water sector. I've outlined many of these in my written testimony. These are strong starting points, but they are insufficient to address the challenge. There is still significant opportunity for Congress to enhance critical infrastructure cyber preparedness. First, Congress should establish baseline cybersecurity requirements or standard of care for critical infrastructure based on effective cyber hygiene and preventative security practices. These should be developed in partnership with stakeholders and aligned with CISA's cross-sector cybersecurity performance goals, the NIST cybersecurity framework, and international standards. Basic cyber hygiene for critical infrastructure operations includes continuous visibility into what assets are on your network, strong identity and access management, discovering and remediating known vulnerabilities, and implementing incident detection and response capabilities. These baseline requirements must also address the challenges of securing converged IT and OT systems. Second, Congress should prioritize robust cybersecurity funding for programs and initiatives aimed at improving OT security. CISA's Cyber Hygiene Program provides a range of cybersecurity assessments to critical infrastructure and other organizations. However, it does not currently include assessments of OT and IoT systems. The program should be expanded and resourced to include these services. Congress should support CISA and the federal civilian executive branch agencies to implement cybersecurity policy recommendations like Binding Operational Directive 2301 and M2404. Protecting our nation's cybersecurity requires comprehensive knowledge of our networks, including conducting inventories of IT, OT, and IoT assets, and prioritizing risk reduction accordingly. CISA and the Office of the National Cyber Director should have adequate budgets to fulfill their missions and continue to break down silos. CISA must serve as an effective operational coordinator to strengthen security in these environments in real time. ONCD should serve as a strategic coordinator across government agencies. And lastly, cybersecurity should be incorporated into infrastructure funding. Modern infrastructure projects rely more on digital technologies and network connectivity, so it is imperative that OT cybersecurity is addressed in all phases of federal infrastructure projects. Recipients should be allowed to allocate funds towards OT security, and any project seeking funding should include a cybersecurity risk assessment. Thank you again, Chairman Garbarino, Ranking Member Swalwell, and members of the subcommittee for the opportunity to testify before you today on our nation's, the critical subject of securing the industrial control systems vital to our nation's water sector. I appreciate the work of this committee and the bipartisan support that is here for cybersecurity. I look forward to the ongoing collaboration to safeguard the IT, OT, and IoT systems that form the foundation of our nation's critical infrastructure, and I'm happy to answer your questions.